was the same idiot who removed my bullets when we got to the swamp in the sea.
Really?
He brought some green leaves, squeezed it together, and rub it. 3 days time, you press it, it will jump
out. We are kidnapped,
okay? Yeah, I was kidnapped. That is the price you pay for fame. That's the side I look at it, from what the angle I look at it. Because this creek, this criminals in the creek, that's the waterways of, the southern part of this country. They have the belief that I'm so wealthy.
Okay.
And some people have to sell me to them that this person, if he's kidnapped, he has so much money. Well, they overestimated me. I'm not a poor man. Though I don't have the kind of money they thought I have. It was quite unfortunate that these people violently came and picked me on the way from a social show. The night I was raining bullets into my car. Luckily, I escaped this. That my wife you saw just now was shot in the head.
Oh.
And she survived. She was shot in the head. It was a very violent attack, and I was taken from there through these food villages to thick forest, and they took me to the high seas, where I spent 30 days and 30 nights.
Terrible.
Well, I don't know. That is why it is good to be clean, and your hands, to be clean, to have a clean heart. That was a very, very traumatic period for me.
Yes.
I was in the swamp in the ocean for 30 days and 30 nights. With little or no food. Not that there was no food, the kind of food they eat.
Yes.
They eat like animals.
Exactly.
They are my fellow Nigerians. They are from the tribe we call Ijo. Yeah, Ijo in the Delta. So they live in the creeks, and their first job is kidnapping. That's what they specialize in doing. They come to the land here, kidnap any of us, take to the high side, seaside, and keep you there, begin to negotiate for ransom. It is when they get sufficient money for you, they let you go. So it was terrible, it was traumatic. Yes.
They won't allow you to sleep. You sleep inside the forest for...
Yes, they have a scaffold on top of the swamp. They put them there like a table. They put you on top. The water will be flowing under it. That is where you manage and sleep. You roll down before you die. You'll be there, you have to get used to it by force. That's all. They live like animals. Some of them sleep on top of branches, trees, all with assault rifle, military assault rifles. That's what. Any given second, they are with rifles. They are with them. So this is terrible.
It's terrible.
Really terribly terrible.
May we thank God.
Yes. God be the glory, I survived it.
When they kidnap you, many Benin people, not just only Benin, you Nigeria, diaspora, people here, are outraged.
Yes, they were. Because even the kidnappers sometimes come from the city. You know, we don't know them. They will take the boat, go to seashore, come down, go to the city to sample opinions. In fact, they now came back, they said he should not die. That is the likelihood that there will be war between the Benins and the Ijos. Because they are in our creek, so they bring a big mosquito net to cover me, so that mosquito will not kill me. They were expecting big money. The whole money they took total about 11 million naira.
We also thank them for releasing you.
Yes,
thank them so much.
They themselves know that I was forcibly taken away. They were not. It is not to. If they want to kill me, just one shot.
Yes.
But their prime interest is how much they can get from me.
Yes, the ransom.
The ransom, yes. And they got it, and what else? They want you to go and prepare because you fight and run away, leave to fight another day, probably so that you can go home and work more. They know what they are doing.
The day they released you, yes, what did you do?
Well, I was so weak and weary that I could not do it. They just brought me out. I was like, I was totally weak. Because I have not been in circulation for such a long time.
Yes.
And no good food, no medication. In fact, they brought me, when I came back in a stretcher to the intensive care in the hospital. And then I started singing again because I was out of everything. I was, I don't know. So I came back, but it was celebration all over the world.
Yes.
Amongst the people that know me.
Even those who don't even know you, we thank God. And what message do you have for all those people who showed you so much love?
I wrote a song to thank them across the world.
Okay. So since you came back, you started doing your tour and everything.
Yeah.
You have been touring the world.
Yeah, no, I have not actually started. Okay. I think I will start now by coming to Canada.
Okay.
I have not really visited anywhere outside Nigeria since I came back.
Oh, okay.
We are the verge of starting now.
Okay. So we are looking at Canada and other countries?
Definitely, when I come back, customary of me and my promoters, every two years I must travel out of the country. Shout out to us, other parts of the Europe, UK, most times the United States of America. So I'm becoming global.
Yes.
Like I always said when he was alive, said you cannot belong, you cannot be, when you say somebody is tribalistic, you cannot be tribalistic when you don't belong to the tribe. My people all over the world, I'm sure there is no country in the world that you cannot find one Benin speaking person.
Yes.
And there, if there is one there, I am there. If there is any Benin man anywhere in the world, even my those who kidnapped me, my daughters, they came back a few days time, started playing my record to me, their phones. Yes, they will be that. Yes. They will start playing my records to me on their phones. They go to cities to go and record my song. And they're playing it and dancing. I've been looking at them.
You've been dancing in front of you.
No, when I'm in captivity. I was so weak that the kind of life that I have not seen before.
Yes.
I can't eat well. One of these, my leg was severed. They came with motorcycles and guns to take me. Yes, it was my motorcycle that they used to take me through the forest before we got to the seashore, before we went to the boat. So the motorcycle fell and one of these, my leg was dislocated. So for that 30 days I was there, I did not stand one day. It's either I am lying down or I'm sitting up, like this, just like that.
So are you not receiving any treatment for your leg?
Why? Where will you get treatment?
Yeah, exactly.
When they are animals. They are just animals. It just. They are animals. They live like animals. They are in the forest. They shoot monkeys and the rest. They roast it and they start eating it without cooking it. They live like animals. They don't eat salt. They don't eat oil. They are just, whatever they cook, they make ever begin to eat it with ordinary beans, as if you are eating yam and beans. That's yam. Major food. Sometimes they come and cook rice like that. They cut plenty of carrot into it and cook it like that. No salt, no oil.
No spices.
No. What do you mean by spices? They eat like that, like animals. And you have no alternative than to eat with them.
Yes, exactly.
And that's exactly what I was doing with them.
But you spend so much time with them. That's
man is the highest in the history of kidnap in this country. I am I stayed longer than everybody that has been kidnapped in this country. In the seashore, in the swamp. Very far in the swamp. They finally, the day they released me, they went to drop me in Cocoa. Through the waterways to Cocoa in Delta State. And I was picked here in Edo State. So that's it.
So you just, were you able to walk when they
went? No, when I came, they just put me in there. When they dropped me, my people just put me in a jeep.
Okay.
And I was taken to the hospital. Okay. When I got to the hospital, I had a stretcher to the treatment room. Until I finished from there, before I started working, I came back home and I was working with a walking stick for about a month or so before I got back to my feet. I'm still feeling it. Yeah. But not the same, I'm strong enough to play and walk and whatever.
Nebo TV is available for sponsorship. Advertise your business, organization, and products on Nebo TV.
The social media almost caught fire.
Yes, oh my God.
They
oh
said,
my
I was in
God.
Here.
Oh my. Some people even produce songs.
Yes, they did. Though I wasn't here when I came back, they're telling me these things. Mm.
Yeah, some people produce songs, some pressing songs, oh my God.
They don't listen to anything. Where we were in the sea, there's no network.
They don't even access social media. No. All those people, I know.
No, what is accessing? These are animals. Some people who will sell you to them, they wait for you till you are kidnapped. They go their own way, this one will go, until they get money. They don't just come. There must be somebody that is an anchor man that will lead them to where they will kidnap you. That's what they do to so many people. I'm not the one. They have kidnapped bigger and richer people than you. Wuji Technica was kidnapped. Bob Israel was kidnapped. Yes, it's just because mine was an exceptional case that the whole world was shaking during my own.
Yes.
Most of them were kidnapped, like Tom Lai.
Tom Lai?
They kidnapped Tom Lai, they killed his wife, killed his two policemen only, killed his driver, and killed his husband. It was him that was left to kill me, until they got his own soul. And they would have killed my wife. They shot her in the head.
Yeah, she's so lucky.
And she survived. We move here. Then I have 5 bullets in my hand. It was the same idiot who removed my bullets when we got to the swamp in the sea.
Really?
They brought some green leaves, squeeze it together, and rub it. 3 days time, they press it. It will jump out like that. That's what's happening. But my wife was taken to the hospital.
They have traditional medicine to
remove
bullets.
They are animals. You know, animals have what they use in the forest for treatment. They just brought the leaves, they squeeze it, I don't know the leaf. They rub it. They thought they start pressing it and the bullet will jump out like that, 5 of them here.
Really?
Yes. You know, animals treat themselves too in the forest. They have the leaves that they will take, they get well. So these people, they are just animals. The difference is that they know how to operate gun and they speak pidgin English. That's all. That's all they know.
They are so professional. Because if they can remove bullets from your skin.
Yeah, they live there. They said they were born in that a swamp. They said they were born there and they were living on their life there. The only fair time they send them to primary school in the cities. They are lucky. They come back to that place to start what their parents are doing. Kidnapping. In fact, they introduced kidnapping to this country, the Jaws. And they are scattered around the creeks. The country, all waterways in the country, you find them around.
Nevertheless, we thank God that they released you.
Yes.
We thank them so much. Yes. Thank them so much.
They got what they want, not accurately. They said they wanted 200 million, but they got 11 million. So what can I say? If you didn't bring it, they will kill you. That's their way.
Yeah, they won't release you for
no,
zero payment.
No,
yeah.
Say for zero payment, no.
No,
you will die. They say human past there. I saw they bringing in small boats. You see some small boats will come through the creek. They say human parts. I say, how do you preserve them? They say they put them in the depth of the swamp. They dip the dead body into the swamping area. It will not get rotten because it will freeze. So that feels like the place is so cold, the forest. From there, those who buy parts from there, they come and begin to cut them up in parts and be selling them. They will see you say, you saw what we did just now. If you don't bring money, we'll kill you. I said, okay. But they make sure they cover me day and night with mosquito nets. There was a day I asked her, you know, you want to kill me, why are you still protecting me? He said, but you will not die here. It's not you we want to kill. It is those who are taking our oil that want to kill. I said, but I don't work for government. Mm-hmm. You know the job I'm doing. He said, mm-hmm. We don't know you. They only said that you are very rich. They are in the ocean sides and sea sides. How do they know me? They know they're animals. But they have serious guns any time. And they have small boat with which they move around.
Mm-hmm.
When they are on top of water, they are just like fish.
Yeah.
They said it's their boat. They were born there. And they know how to handle water.
Water, yes. They can swim like fish.
They make sure they protect you not to fall in. Because they know you will die.
Yeah,
they will protect you when the boat is flying. You see that this one will hold you and this one will hold you tight. They are there even if your legs are in the water. Mm. The boat is going. They take you to safety first before they start doing what they want to do. Yeah, that's part of it. That's part of life.
Thank God,
the price you pay for fame.
Your awards, you say you're going to show us some of the awards they gave you. Can we see some of them?
There's a commissioner of police in Edo State, Omar Araba from captivity.
Oh, they gave you an award.
Yeah, I was
here. Thank you, sir.
Professor Victor Waifu.
Oh, yeah. I went to his place when I came.
These are all series of
awards.
I'm just keeping them. I'm preparing an archive for them. This was given to me in 1992. That's the Commonwealth of Massachusetts in the United States.
Okay, they give it to you in the United States?
As you can read.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
In the U.S.
Oh, yeah. U.S., yeah.
It's an official citation of me. Yeah, their signatures was given to me in America in 1992.
Long time ago.
Okay, I said it before. Now, this is a different scene. Before one, when I came back from captivity, this one.
They gave you a...
Then this one is in the... in New York City.
Honorable Osayomore Joseph.
How was it there? They named me the ambassador of the Edo music.
King of Ulele Power Sound.
Yes.
Yes. Are you exercising?
Yes, of course, because it is my small dream.
Oh, okay. This is you, and Adam
Osayomore,
the former governor.
Yes.
This is it. I think this is an artwork.
No.
This real picture?
It's real. Oh. I was in the stadium.
Oh, okay.
So for that, I'm building a knife very soon. Several others like that.
This young you, when you were young. Look at you, different.
This was in 1997.
Long time ago.
Okay, yes.
Young you.
Yes, sir. He said that Papa was a lobbyist.